Is everyone being nice to you?
Absolutely.
Really?
At Brennan's in the French Quarter, General Manager Christian Pendleton runs the place like a sergeant in the army of appetizers.
Drinking.
He was, after all, a special ops sergeant in the army.
Were you nice to him today?
These days, Christian can be called into active duty to exercise his constitutional right to bear arms. His weapon of choice is a sword or a saber. It's how he properly pops the top off a bottle of champagne.
Like a racehorse out of the gate. Like a rocket launched into space. Nice sound effects. How does this compare to that?
Drinking champagne is fun and it starts at the top.
Sabering, as it's called, is a not so big chapter in beverage history, but it does go all the way back to Napoleon.
And here, Christian Pendleton has the history in his heart. Yeah, right there. To turn back time, let's turn back to black and white. Oh, that tickled a little bit. And some appropriate music to set the mood.
Sabering champagne started back in the time of the Widow Clicquot, Veuve Clicquot, the yellow label champagne. When her husband passed, she asked Napoleon's Imperial Guard to help protect her grounds. When the officers would change command, she would thank them by presenting them with a bottle of champagne. Well, when you're riding horseback, it's very difficult to open champagne properly. So they would simply draw their sabers, shear off the top, and ride away.
From Napoleon in the day to today at the proud pink palace in New Orleans, where it's not about the sharpness of the blade, it's the skill of the soldier wielding the weapon. Christian can do it with a butter knife. Better butter up and savor the moment for a sip of champagne and a slice of life. Bill Wood, WGNO News.